So here's this shape, guys. Looks like a, I think it looks like a boxing ring. We take a look at the original drawing here, right? So here's my goal. My goal is to draw now these cylinders that are going around the perimeter of this boxing ring, okay, right here, see it? So how do you draw those? It's a little bit tricky, but you're gonna have to create an offset plane and draw a circle. Two concentric circles, extrude it. And so it's a little bit of a task to make that happen. All right, so some key dimensions are right in here in this little area, right here. It talks about like how high that tube is off of the cylindrical corner. So it's like, I think it's 7 units above there from the center line. And yeah, so it's a little bit tricky. And then you got to think that the tubes themselves, when you look at them here, they're 15 units high. So that center line is 7.5, it's the halfway. And so yeah, we're gonna have to figure that out. Then the tubes themselves have a diameter of 20, these corner tubes. This has a diameter of 8. So yeah, keeping all that in mind, diameter of 8, and then I think the inside of it's radius of 2, which means 4. I can't move over there. Yeah, 2 and 4. So we got to use that information. So here we go. So I'm gonna run with this. So I'm on the front view. I'm gonna go to the bottom view. So let me just click here first. Go to bottom. Oh, that's the bottom view. Yep. And I'm gonna create. Okay, so I'm going to now draw a plane along one of these cylinders. So if I take a look at the cylinder, I'm gonna zoom in. I'm gonna draw a plane that kind of slices it. It's gonna be vertical. I'll draw that circle that we need that shows up here. See these circles on this sectional view right in here? You'll see it right, where's it at? Where's it at? Right there, see that? I'm gonna draw one of those guys. So let's figure out, let's go to construct, offset plane. I'm gonna pick this vertical plane right in here. Gotta make sure it's the right one. So let me rotate. I think it's that one right here. And I'm gonna offset that by looking at these numbers. it's 45, 48. And yeah, 48. So 48. Now that pushed that back. I need to flip it. And so I'm going to make it negative 48. There you go. I wanted it forward up here. Choose OK. So there's that plane. But what I'm going to do with that too is I'm going to drag this corner over here. Drag this other corner over here. So it's kind of hovering right in this area. So there it is. What I'm going to draw are some construction lines now to set this up so that I don't make too many mistakes. And so I'm going to click on the plane, right? And I'm going to draw a construction line. Line type of construction. And it's going to be horizontal. And I'll draw another one vertically. Now watch how I set this up. They've got to be in a specific spot. Now that horizontal construction line needs to be, according to the direction, 7.5 units off of this top edge. So let's go to the dimension tool. Let's click on this edge and this construction line, and that needs to be 7.5. And then this other construction line, since the diameter of this large cylinder here, the outer edges, is 10. No, no, is it 10? 20? No, it's 20. Then this has to be half of that, or 5. So let's go from this edge. Oh, wow, that's not an edge I can choose. So let's go to projection here really quick. Let's project this edge. Will it show up? Let's see. Is that an edge that I can see? I don't know. We'll find out. So let's go here to the bodies and see if that works. Oh, there we go. Project the body. So I had to go modify here. I want to see the body itself and create projection edges on that. So there it is. I choose OK. Now these edges are available. See it? So that's how I can use my dimension tool. Finish. Let's go from this edge to this edge here. That needs to be 10. Let's click and type 10. Choose OK. We're looking good. So now that I have this this construction area, I want to see what it looks like here. Let me get rid of that. Here, escape the keyboard, I think. Nope. Wrong button. Yeah, we go. So let's rotate. Yeah, it's in the perfect spot. It's exactly what I want. Now there's a center point there. I hope I can access it and draw this circle here. So I'm gonna go finish sketch. Actually, I didn't want to finish the sketch. So once you do something like that, you want to go back to that sketch. Just go to the timeline. Go edit. Now let's go to circle. Here we go. We want to go to a circle. We want the center of the circle right here. Let's see if I got to it. Right there. Good. Click. And I drag that. Make it 4. Enter. Do it again. Click. Drag that. Open it up. I guess not. Let's try it again. Click, drag that, and make it 8. 4 and 8, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. So there you have it. I'm going to finish that sketch and drag these. Well, I should have dragged those out, but here's what it looks like, those dimension markings. It's there. It's right in the middle. Now I'm going to drag that and extrude it so that it ends up in the right spot, right? It's crazy looking there, but I'm going to move that this way. So let's just zoom out just a hair. All right. So drag this down just a hair. So let's see if I can do this. So now I go to extrude. Click on that region. Drag this 96 units. Now it says it's a cut. I don't want it to cut. I want it to be a join. See that? And it's kind of weird. Or new body, how's that? New body. So I click new body. New body. And hey, new body, okay. So that's gonna be 96 units. Perfect. Let's go okay. And there it is. Looks like it's in the right spot. It's dimensioned correctly. But that's just one. So you see the excess inside of it? I'm going to clean that up. Here's how you do that. First thing you do is you want to make this cylindrical tube two separate bodies at the intersection. So I do that by going to modify, split, the body. So I click on the actual tube. That's called body to split. And then the splitting tool is the actual cylinder itself. See that? And that turns red. That's the cutting tool on the inside edge. Choose OK. And now when I click on the body, it's two separate parts. See it? So this part over here, you want to remove it. Not delete it, just remove it. So that's a body. If you go to the bodies over here in the browser, which body is it? I think it's body 6. There it is. See it when I hover? If you right click on that, there's an option called remove. You want to choose remove, not delete. And the remove tool leaves a special icon on the timeline that allows you to, let's say if you wanted to see it again, you could go back and see it prior to it being removed. And it makes more sense to keep the original shape intact. Okay. Do the same thing on this side. Go back to modify. Split the body. Click. Splitting tool. Cylinder. okay, this here again is this body here called 7. Right click, remove, and there you have it. That's one. We need three more. Well, there are some shortcuts. Let's use the reflection tool, which is create a mirror. What do we want to mirror? I want to select this object. Now again, object type, is it a body? Is it a face? Is it a feature? This is a body. Let's select it. And let's select the mirroring plane, which is this one here. And there it is, flipped right over. All right, so now that I have that, I should be able to rotate, make a copy of this, rotate it maybe 90 degrees. And but I'm not 100% certain. We're going to find out if this is possible. See if I can rotate this 90 degrees. All right, so let me just see if this will work. Okay, I think it's going to work. Let's check this out. So I'm going to take this here, and I'm going to rotate it. So I'm going to go to the Move tool here, and I'm under Bodies, right? I'm under Bodies, that's what I'm on. This is a body. And the Move type is going to be a rotation, 90 degrees. So it says to select that shape. Then it says select the axis of rotation. So it's going to revolve around this cylinder. So I click on the cylinder. Oh, wrong selection. Let me try it again. Body. Select the cylinder as the rotation. Okay, then I'm going to click on create a copy. And now when you rotate this little knob here, see the degrees? It's rotating the copy around. And make sure it's 90 degrees. Yep, perfect. Choose OK. And there it is. Do the same thing again, but we'll do it in the other direction. Let's go copy. I could also reflect if I wanted to, but I'll do another one. Let's click on that. Axis here. Make a copy. And 90 degrees. OK. And there it is. It worked. Now you can poke some of these things in the eye. Looks like I have something there showing up. Looks like the square base. What's showing up there? Is it the body that's showing up? Oh, the sketch. There you go. Well, there you have it. It's exactly what you wanted. All right, like I always say, you study hard, you learn a lot. And we will see you soon.